Hello, YouTube. It's Alex in Disneyland. This is being filmed on a phone because I'm too lazy to go get all the stuff set up camera. And fluffy puppy. So, I've been gone for a while from YouTube. Either I've been busy with school, acting, or I just haven't felt like it. So, that's why I've been gone for so long. So, I decided yesterday, my friend, Seth, he owns the channel Seth Rack. He posted on a channel that belongs to his friends and him, which is his top three songs, shows, and movies. I like the idea. And I decided I kind of want to just do a version of it, except only songs, since music's one of the main things I like these days. So I decided to, I posted a comment of my stuff that I could think of. I was thinking of it for like 2 seconds, so I wasn't really thought through. This list is a little bit more thought through. No script other than the song choices, which are in no particular order, by the way. I'm just going to say what I see lists on first on the list. I'll explain why I like it. And while I'm explaining it, it'll be in the background. So, let's start. So, for our first song, this one is going to be kind of cheating because it's technically multiple songs, but the Abbey Road Medley by the Beatles. So, the time when this album, Abbey Road, was released, it was their second to last album to release, but it was the last one they wrote. At the time, the Beatles, their manager died a couple albums ago. They had one of the worst albums in their career. They just finished writing it, which is Let It Be. By the way, I hate that album. There's only one song I like on it. And then before that, they did the White Album, which also doesn't really have very many good songs other than, can't even think of any, off the top of my head. Then, of course, this time they had some good singles. Hey Jude came around this time, but other than that, the Beatles were really in a bad place. So, of course, I forgot who it was, but someone wanted to do, like, a whole ton of interconnecting songs. Of course, Lennon did not want to do this, McCartney did. So what they did is, the first side, because back then they had records and they had two sides. First side was just a whole ton of just songs for Abbey Road. I can only think of one off the top of my head, it was kind of forgettable other than Come Together. But the second side is where all the popular songs are. Second side, you have one of the most popular Beatles songs, Here Comes the Sun. Then you get the medley, which is every other song. Well, depends. The version of the medley I'm putting on this list is Because, You Never Give Me Your Money, Mean Mr. Mustard, Sun King, Cheating Through the Bathroom Window, Puffy Pine, Boom Slumbers, Carry That Weight, and The End. No Her Majesty, I actually own albums, so I actually use Adobe Audition to professionally put together all the songs. I couldn't get that one in there, but I think it's great. I think it's a masterpiece. So, on to number two. Number two is Paint It Black by the Rolling Stones. This is the first Rolling Stones song I ever heard, and it's probably their best. I don't know the album, but the Rolling Stones have a whole ton of good ones. They have Shattered, Miss You, a whole ton of good ones, but this one's always my favorite from them. It just has that, I just like the tone, I like the rhythm of it, it's very catchy, and I just think it's a really good song. There's not much I can say about this one. The Rolling Stones are great, one of my favorite bands, along with Beatles and Cars, which thing of it, I didn't have Cars, so, on to number three, which is We Didn't Start the Fire by Billy Joel. I don't know what to say about it, it's just really catchy, that's really it. The song goes through different time periods. Like, it starts somewhere in like the 40s, then it has like multiple events for every year. And when I was first actually paying attention to it, there's one part, I'm a Disney fan, as you can tell by the shirt. There's one part that was Davy Crockett, Peter Pan, and then Disneyland. I was like, what? Disneyland? It's just cool to see. Wasn't it a little autumn pup? Oh, and by the way, in some of my older videos, you sometimes hear me calling Autumn. This is Autumn. Fluffy pup. Number four is Help, again, by the Beatles. this is actually one... The Beatles have some of the best albums. The three best Beatles albums are on. The third best is Abbey Road. The second best was Revolver. I mean, Abbey Road's only third because of the medley, which is amazing. Revolver just has a whole ton of good songs. But my favorite album, this is the first song on my favorite album, Help. So the song is Help, and the album is Help. It has some of my favorite Beatles songs I saw. No, not that one. I've Just Seen a Face, and Help's just a great song. I saw her stand. No. Sorry. I've Just Seen a Face in one of the first Beatles songs I heard. I actually didn't. The first time I heard I Saw Her Standing There was actually not Beatles. And Help's just really catchy. Before I do my fifth song, which is probably one of my favorites, I'm going to do a handful of honorable mentions that I just think of on the top of my head.
I know tonight she comes. She's taking a swipe at fun.
McCartney, in my opinion, is my favorite Beatles, so pretty much everything he does on his own I like. Which brings me to my final one, which is ironically Live or Let Die by the Beatles. It's not by the Beatles. Live or Let Die by Paul McCartney, I'm sorry. I can't wait for the hate comments from all my mistakes in this video. Live or Let Die is, in my opinion, the best Bond theme. I don't really remember any of the other ones. The first Bond, I've only seen two Bond films, which are the Casino Royale and Spectre. I also saw the intro of a couple others, like Skyfall. But Live or Let Die is just such a catchy song and tune, and it was written by Paul McCartney. I don't think it could have been better. It's not my favorite song, but it's definitely my favorite by him, just him. I mean, this list is forgetting so many. It's forgetting B-52s and Tom Petty, but this is pretty much what I can come up with. And I have school in 2 weeks, so don't expect any other videos for another year. Or more. Or until I start playing Geometry Dash again. But other than that, see you later, YouTube.